presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hey, Robert, how you doing, man?
Yes, and thank you for taking my call. I wanted to let you know that I've been a subscriber for a couple of years, just different members of your team, and I really enjoy it. But really the reason I'm calling is to express my sincerest gratitude for you providing that information yesterday on the small business grant. I'm a small business owner and primary breadwinner for my family, and if I can get that money, it's going to really mean a lot to my family. So
that's awesome.
Thank you for taking the time to do that.
No, well, listen, man, we appreciate you growling a problem with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's making a great night, folks. Always do your best. Take action on your ideas. I love this card, folks. Doing your best means take action on your ideas. You can have many ideas in your head, but without action upon an idea, there'll be no manifestation, no results, and no reward. Marketers, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 107, NASDAQ up 47, S&P's up 3.5, gold contract down $2.10, trading $18.54 an ounce. You got silver down 15 cents, $25.40 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 46 cents, $52.73 a barrel. Notes and bonds. 10-year note up 10 ticks, trading 137.11. The 30-year is up a full point, plus a tick at 169.29. Now, both notes and bonds, folks, bottom line, you know, higher price, lower yield. The 10-year got back inside its larger range, higher range last week. Now it's pulling way up. The 30-year is only three ticks away from getting back inside its higher range. That was after the five-day downdraft. Bottom line, we get the Fed meeting starting tomorrow. You get the statement on Tuesday. On Wednesday at 2 o'clock, you can expect some volatility inside these markets, particularly inside the notes, bonds, currencies. Dollar. Dollar right now trading up at 153, trading at 90.392. The euro is out here at 121. The yen is at 103.80. And the British pound is at 136 to 1 U.S. dollar. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Dave Mazza, head of product and managing director at Direction. And bottom line, folks, okay, I know as you come over to our website and you're at our website listening right now, you see the Direction banner. Bottom line, you can hit that banner. You want to understand everything and anything about these leverage products. I know many of our Tigers and Tigers has trade these products each and every day. Dave Mazza, what's going on?
Hey, thanks for having me back.
Absolutely. Well, I can tell you, Dave, this is going to be a heck of a week, man. I mean, right, we get the Fed meeting tomorrow, going to Wednesday. We got Microsoft. We get Apple. We get Tesla. We got the GDP. I mean, where do they want to start?
Yeah, you name it. And look, in the last 2 days, it's been the GameStop market with what's been going on with that particular security. And then you got calls on one hand from world famous investors that were in a bubble. But I think this week is going to separate a lot of that noise, meaning we're gonna get reads from the FOMC, and they're likely going to just confirm what they've been alluding to, that accommodation is here. So what that does is, when we do get this inevitable dip or an inevitable correction, the more people call for a correction, guess what? One day you get one. Might be another buying opportunity here, or definitely at least a trading opportunity. And this week's gonna be special, to your point, with all these big tech earnings coming out, to see just how well they fared navigating, of course, this interesting environment, but also positioning for what eventually is the new normal as we continue to have this push-pull of what the virus is doing and how fast we can get the science and the vaccines into people's arms.
There's no doubt. And folks, as you go over to the Direction website, you're going to see right on the front page, one of them in particular, work from home, WFH. And the reason I want to bring this up, okay, is at the Supreme Court right now. There's going to be a really cool case. And, of course, bottom line, are you in Massachusetts, Dave? You're in Massachusetts, right? Are you working out of New York?
I'm actually in New York.
You're working out of New York. Okay.
We have plenty of folks in Mass, yeah.
Right. So what's going on here, folks, is this, is that New Hampshire and Mass are fighting it out over the aspect of that, okay, there's so many people up in New Hampshire that literally New Hampshire folks are right next to Boston. I mean, you know, it's 45 minutes away. And it's about the tax structure. And so it's really cool. Direction has this ETF, folks, is work from home. Now, this has been very successful anyway because of the way that the allocations and the holdings are. You know what's going to be interesting here, Dave, right? I mean, when I heard this morning on the way into work, I says, oh, my God, because it's going to make a difference with the Supreme. So the argument, folks, is this, is that you get a lot of jobs in Massachusetts. The people in New Hampshire have been home now a good, some of them 6 months. Why should they pay taxes in Massachusetts on top of that? You know, so when I heard that, the first thing I thought of actually was this work from home, because that's going to, I mean, we're in a different era now, there's no doubt. So we'll see what they end up saying about where the taxes are going to be paid. But it looks to me like there's a whole different environment out here now.
That's really the whole point. So, yeah, our work from home ETF, $150 million in assets after launching in June of last year. And it's really about, this is not a leverage fund, but we do have folks who own it for the long term, folks who have gotten in and out of it, depending upon whatever analysis they're doing. But, you know, it's pulled back slightly today, but it was making some new highs last week as, again, even if people think that we are going to we will eventually have a more normalized economic environment, the idea that more folks will be working remotely and not as many folks in the office at one time continues to benefit the names in the portfolio. And these are names that are directly related to what we need for a safe working from home environment. So that's cybersecurity, particularly important when you have folks in disparate locations. You have kind of your content management, document management companies. You have your remote communication companies like your Zooms and your Twilios. But then you also have your cloud companies, right? So your best of clouds are in that portfolio too, to give you that full perspective of what, in our opinion, the 40 stocks that are going to benefit most from this long-term trend toward what I consider to be a hybrid working environment. So some folks in the office, some folks in other locations, swapping out, coming together for when you need to. But also sometimes if you need that day at home, you might actually be more effective. Don't have the commute, or can just, if you have individual work that needs to get done, can do that.
You know what I think is so great too? I think it's great that it's not leveraged. And the reason being, folks, is this. You know, we all wish that we bought Apple when it was like $3. Okay, we know that things have changed. Okay, so you're talking about a fund that's not leveraged. You can take it in your IRA. You can put it wherever you want to put it. And of course, you're in a probability as an investor. But this is a new era, and you're talking about great companies, man. And that's what you have inside this, Dave, which is really cool, man. I mean, you know, we always want to go back in time, but guess what? This is in time in this particular case.
Yeah, that's the whole idea. You know, people talk about buying, reference Apple, buying the new iPhones, you should have bought the stock. And so you have the example of work from home. But for traders, like we talked about last week, we have our new cloud ETFs, Cloud L and Cloud S, 2X bull and bear funds.
Absolutely. Check them out right on the front page of TFNN, folks. Dave, you have a great one, safe one. We look forward to speaking to you in a couple of weeks.
Talk soon.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about the Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive the Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on the Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 151. You got the NASDAQ up 19. S&P's turning red. They're down 2 right now. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, as we do each and every Monday at 20 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Steve has an outstanding show here every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also a great newsletter in Mastering Probability. Now, it's very easy to get Mastering Probability. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right under Featured Content. You just hit Mastering Probability. You hit Subscribe. You can get Mastering Probability for 1 month for $149. You can get it for 6 months for $695, which is a savings of $199 or 22%. And you can get it for a year for $1,195, which is a savings of $593 or 33%. Now, they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, folks. So when you're going over there, take your choice which one you like. If you like it at the end of 30 days, great, no problem. If it doesn't work for you, guess what? You get your money back. So check it out. You get everything to win, zero to lose. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
History, baby. History is going to be rewritten in 2 weeks in Tampa.
I'm telling you, it's pretty wild. Let me tell you, when I was just going through your newsletter, I was going to say to them, and hey, listen, you're not going to get a call like you're not going for it on the fourth down with Aaron Rodgers as your quarterback.
That is true. That's true.
We lucked out, man.
Yeah. So it was a great first half. You know, you probably were feeling pretty good. And then that second half, probably some fingernails being bitten.
Seriously, man. I mean, you know, Brady had 3 interceptions, folks, which is unheard of. Bottom line, that defense that Tampa has is pretty amazing, man. There's no doubt. It is.
So Tom, it's Super Bowl 55. There's going to be some records or certainly history that's going to be written. So there's 10 obvious things that are out there. So, for example, the oldest coach to win the Super Bowl so far is Belichick.
Okay.
And he's 66. So Arians is 68. Tampa wins.
Okay.
He gets that record.
Cool.
The first quarterback to win a Super Bowl in 3 different decades is what Brady is trying to do.
Wow.
So that's pretty miraculous. If the Chiefs win, then Andy Reid, he gets to join this elite company of coaches that have 2 Super Bowl wins. There's about a half a dozen guys that are out there that do that.
Okay.
Mahomes, he could join the list of multiple MVP winners. There's just a handful of guys out there. Mahomes could also – here's the real rub. Mahomes could take over Brady being the youngest quarterback. So right now, Brady's youngest quarterback at age 26 to have won a Super Bowl.
Okay.
Mahomes is 25.
Wow.
Come Sunday. So Brady's going to – I think, you know, guys get those records. They like to keep them.
Oh,
so
yeah.
He's, He's got motive. He's got lots of motivation out there. The all-time conference. So the interesting thing, this is Super Bowl 55, and the record between the NFC and AFC, it's 27-27.
Really?
So, yeah. Wow. So that's going to fall, obviously, to one side. The Chiefs can become the first team since 2003 to win back-to-back rings out there. Brady, he could match Peyton Manning as the only quarterback to win with two franchises. Brady could also join Plunkett, Elway, Dilfer, Roethlisberger, Manning, and Rodgers with being a wild card winner, taking a wild card team to the Super Bowl. And then the most important record of all, the Buccaneers can become the first home team to win a Super Bowl. So pretty cool. I checked just before I got on the air, and you can get the nosebleed seats right now for about $8,000.
I'm wondering how many people they're going to let into the stadium. I know. That's what's going to get interesting, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And so because there's limited supply, I don't expect that we would see prices fall.
Yeah, right.
You know, they were playing the Orange Bowl game, some games down here in Florida. And I had thought about going to some of the college games. I thought about going to those games. When I, reduced attendance that was in there, and the seats just never came down in price to make it, worthwhile to go.
Yeah.
I've been to both Super Bowls in Tampa. The first one I think was back in 84. The other one was in 91, and a couple Super Bowls down in Miami. I'll be watching this one on television, but it should be great. And I'm sure you're looking forward to it. And Tampa has got to be high energy.
Oh, there's no doubt. I mean, we won the Stanley Cup. Now, you get Brady and it's a great, and the team is so phenomenal, man. I mean, it's just not absolutely Brady, folks. And you could see that with him yesterday when, the news, they just wanted to keep talking. He says, hey, man, he just gave the trophy. He says, like, talking to someone else, get someone else up here.
Exactly.
And that was so cool. It was unbelievable. I mean, I was like, hey, man, Yeah.
I caught that too. And that was great. And so I'm looking forward to the game. I'm sure you are as well. So just quickly in moving over to the markets out here, just to try to get a feel. I don't have a ton, but a few things for us to take a look at. And so we'll take a look at the Dow. And this chart here, Tom, takes a look at the Dow priced in dollars on the very left-hand side. Then next to that is taking a look at the Dow priced in euros, then yen, and then in pounds out here. And you'll see a couple of yellow horizontal lines that we're keying in on. So just the simplest thing for listeners out there, they don't have to be technicians to understand this. If you're in an instrument, whatever that instrument is, and especially in the beginning of the year out here, because in that beginning of the year, January, we have this cycle that the markets typically move lower into the end of January, like right around now, between the 25th and the 30th. We haven't seen that take place out here. But the simple thing is, if you are trading above the 2020, in this case here, the 2020 close, it's really a bullish sign.
Right.
And most certainly if you're trading above the prior high. So this is something that folks can – now, when I take a look at this, what this means to me out here. So we have the Dow trading above the 2020 close in all of these currencies. And that's important for folks to understand, because in a bull market or a bear market, you want to say things either rising in all currencies or moving lower in all currencies. If you've got something rising in two currencies but falling in two currencies, well, then you've got your natural buyer and seller out there. So bull market, you want to see everything moving higher. Right now, we've got that just by a smidgen out here. But what we don't have, we don't have the Dow priced in euros trading above the 2020 high. If it does that, it will confirm, or may confirm, that we've got a global flow of capital that is focused in on the Dow. And the same would hold true for the yen. It still hasn't gotten up to the 2020 highs. The priced in pounds, the Dow actually tagged its level, which is 22.803. It's trading just below it right now. So this is what I'm watching closely to look for, some type of confirmation that capital is flowing into the Dow. As we speak right now, the only place where I can find capital flowing into is actually in the Hang Seng. And if I can find
it. Yeah, that's on fire, right. Yeah.
It is. And what I do is I pay attention to – it's probably right here. Yeah. So this this table right here takes a look at the major indices, Tom. When I say major indices, I've got the Dow, the DAX, the FTSE, the Shanghai. I'm also taking a look at other major instruments, gold, T-bonds, the currency marketplace, the commodity index, light sweet crude, emerging markets, the Australian 200 index, the Hang Seng, the Nikkei, and then the S&P 500. And if we take a look at this is taking a look at what the rate of change has been since the beginning of the year, since the first trading day in 2021. And right now, the leader out here is the Hang Seng. Now, this is also important to watch because what I'm looking for here, now that the elections are done in the U.S., is it's now global capital's time to vote. And where's global capital going to go ahead and park itself? And what it does, we usually see these rates of change in these major currencies really pull away from all of the other indices or instruments that are out there. So, folks, we should keep our eye on the Shanghai, and especially last night, because the Shanghai last night, Tom, took out a key resistance level, and it is suggesting that it wants to continue to move higher.
Yeah, no doubt. Listen, folks, come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see Master and Probability right under featured content. You just hit that button, and you subscribe. Steve, you have a great one, safe one. We look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thanks, Tom.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS profile scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hinks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market. Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour. Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m. Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m. And Tom O'Brien closes out the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's down a buck 20. NASDAQ is up 25. S&P's a flat. And we got to get over to GameStop, folks. So you're talking about volatility. This is the ultimate volatility move out here today. No doubt. And what you had is that you had GameStop, bottom line, opened higher, end up going up to, so check this out. On Friday, folks, we closed at $64. Opens up this morning at about, let's see, where is it? 96. Goes all the way up to, folks, $159. And then goes by, boom. Actually, when Tommy and I were in the air, it took the first leg down. But needless to say, it kept going lower. And then hit a low of 61. Right now, you're at 77. though, this baby, this is just like, you know, a little bubble, yeah, in a monster way. No doubt about that. Now, another one that was, let's go take a look at this one, because once these start popping up, folks, okay, the bottom line is that people start hunting them down. There it is. This popped too. Bed Bath & Beyond. Okay, so what happens is that, you know, you get traders start hunting them. They start hunting them. They start running them in a big way. No doubt about that. Bottom line is that they did it with Bed Bath & Beyond this morning also. The low for Bed Bath & Beyond is $3.43. The high is $47. Bed Bath & Beyond here went, it closed on Friday at $29. Opens this morning at $34. Runs to 47, and then ba-boom, does the same deal. Pretty intense, man. There's no doubt about it. And what I was talking about this morning is that when you are in a market like this, this won't be the end of this, folks. That's the real bottom line, is that when you see a couple of these, you're going to get more of these, okay? We'll go from there, but it's pretty intense. Some of the other higher volume equities out here in this market today, you had, Apple's the big dog. Apple's, and of course, Apple makes money, okay? So bottom line is that it's going to be intriguing when Apple comes out. Actually, I believe Apple wants to bring to the top line $120 billion in 90 days. This is always their largest quarter, folks, because it's the holiday quarter. So let's see. They're going to look to bring, $103 billion to their top line, and $1.41 to their bottom line. Last year on this quarter, they did $91 billion. This is always their biggest quarter. They're still looking to basically grow over a three-year period about 8%. That's what they're looking at. Let's go take a look at FIZZ. See what this baby is. So this is National Beverage. Okay, so let's see. So is this only, this hit a low today of $33. Oh, my. Oh, I see. Thank you, Dan. So what I was talking about this morning, folks, is that when traders start hunting for them, they just hunt for high shot positions. And sure enough, this one here had a 62% shot position in it. Oh, my God. Look at this thing. This is, okay, so what you had here is that this thing closed on Friday at a price point of 96. And, oh, was that Friday's? 1 second. I got this on a daily. Yeah, I believe I got this on a daily. Yeah, so it closed at 96, ran all day. It ran, folks, from a price point of 100 up to 140. And then also, pulled back down. And there's going to be some damage. Well, there's damage out there. That's the real bottom line. So picture what does happen in this type of squeeze intraday, folks. Intraday, what ends up happening is this. Depending on the type of margin account you have. If you have a portfolio margin account, what the portfolio margin account ends up being is that they actually do let you leverage almost like 9 to 1, okay, intraday. But the reason for that is that there's going to be $500,000 million inside that account. They better be. That's how it normally works. There's a lot of retail traders that have that, okay? Now, that's a very easy way to get basically blown up, okay? I suspect most of the GameStop one was institutional money. But it doesn't mean that institutional money also can't blow up. And so what tends to happen is that you see a stock that's running like this, that whoever the bank is, that's basically their broker-dealer, or the broker-dealer in general, but most of the large funds are going to have a bank, plus, and the bank is going to be their broker-dealer. They're going to basically either shut them out, sell them out, and once the selling gets sold out, that's when you see that they start pulling back again, because all it's done. You know, now we'll see if that's going to be the reason, if that's why that baby, you know, did it. And as we're talking here, I know one of the Tigers put something in here, and I was talking about this morning that we're going to find out that someone basically is going to get hurt. So Melville, Melville Capital, which we learned last week had suffered massive losses on a shot, is set to receive a $2.7 billion injection from hedge fund Citadel and Point72 as investors appear to bail out the founder, former star portfolio manager Steve Cohen, could pay his margin call. The bailout investments are for non-controlling revenue shares in the hedge fund. Well, that, it doesn't say that he was involved in GameStop, but maybe he was. This one doesn't say that anyway. When you have something that's this dramatic, folks, you always get this type of news coming down. Someone always ends up, well, how could you not get hurt? that's what it really comes down to. MRO, let's go take a look at one of the oil stocks out here from one of the Tigers. Marathon Oil. Marathon Oil, lows $3, the highs 12. That high was hit February of last year. The low was in April. Okay, so this one here, so the question they had is an ABC up. This is going to be a complex ABC up, I think. Okay, let me put this on a weekly because I think it already hit one ABC. Oh, this is cool. It's a weekly ABC. Yeah, so this is cool when it goes like this. So you get a weekly ABC up anyway, 740. It's approximately $4, which gets you about $10. Okay, so watch how this shakes out. This is a weekly ABC up approximately $9.50 to $10 anyway. And that's on the weekly. Now, on the daily, what it did and it is doing, it had broken topside. You broke topside. You had the juice on the way up. You pull back. You're pulling back into the breakout area. Just finished closing a gap. The gap there was at $7.67. We had $7.62 today. Rejected lower price. Bottom line is that, yes, higher price can be coming at you inside of MRO. Let's go take a look at the oil contract itself. So the oil contract, let's see, we're in February right now. No, it's not. We're not in February. That's not the active one. CL. There we go. Yeah, we're in March. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. And if we take a look at this oil contract, so, oil's consolidating up here. There's no reason this oil doesn't basically still want to try to bust into the $60 level. You know, this contract here has a high of 55. Right now, we're in the March contract. That's how that thing's shaking up. If we go back to that fund for a second, I got a story on Bloomberg right now. This is a sad story, man. I mean, the bottom line is that this guy, he had worked for Point 12, which is Steve Cohen's company. Here's Cohen's statement. He has known the leader here since 2006. He's an exceptional investor and leader. But the bottom line is that they're bailing them out, and we'll see what the deal is. So you got Ken Griffin, Steve Cohen, boasted Melvin's capital by injecting $2.75 billion in the firm after it lost 15% in the first 3 weeks of the year. Citadel Funds and firm partners will invest $2 billion, while .72 Asset Management is going to invest $750 million. The capital infusion comes after Melville Capital, which started the year with $12.5 billion in assets, had seen its shot bets, including GameStop Corp, go awry, spurring big losses, according to the people familiar with the firm. And now listen to this, man. This is pretty intense, man, because this guy's really done well. But watch this. Listen to this, folks. Now, this is a heads up for everyone, because you don't see people that actually can make 30% a year. Oh, no. Well, it only started in 2014. Well, that's still 6 years, man. So this guy started the firm in 2014, and he's averaged 30% per year for 6 years. What the Citadel founder, Ken Griffin, who's a monster in the business, said his team, Greg Plotkin and his team had delivered exceptional results over the history of Melvin. We have great confidence in Gab and his team, and evidently they definitely do, because they put up the money. So, you know what's going to be intriguing about that trade, folks, is that, so he got the call, the margin call. The real question is, did he get the money, okay, soon enough to make the call? Okay, that's the first part. Now, as one of our tigers is saying there, is that, well, one of them was Citadel. So the bottom line is that, was Citadel himself the broker-dealer inside of the deal? It doesn't say that. And Citadel realistically makes... Well, it makes all its money by... I believe Citadel, folks, has... I think it's 47% of all retail trade goes through Citadel. Institutional trade, they're at about 27-28%. This guy prints money. So I don't think he actually has accounts. I don't think he's set up as a broker. He might be set up as a broker-dealer just for his own internal... Yeah, he'd be set up as a broker-dealer for his own internal... deal. Yeah, Citadel is in securities, but I believe what he is set up in the aspect of the because of the platforms. So here, let me just explain what I'm saying here. You have broker dealers and that TD Ameritrade, Fidelity, and all this, okay? Then you have the banks, okay, that have it both ways. They have the banking structure, they have the broker dealer, okay? Then you have someone like Citadel, which is actually everything is going through it, and Citadel is turning around and saying to the other broker dealers, I'm going to pay you for order flow. You're going to bring this through me. And that's what Citadel does, okay? Bottom line is that that may be just the first one of a bunch of them. And one of our other targets, we're talking about the long-term capital. And this is phenomenal, folks. So this is what you always want to remember going forward, too. Long-term capital almost took down the whole system. This was 1998, and I was right in front of machines then. We were actually still live on the air. This was pretty wild, watching this come down. And long-term capital had only lost 3.5. They only needed a $3.5 billion bailout, and that almost took down the whole system. So you can see if folks tell you that, well, we haven't had inflation. Well, we have definitely had inflation, folks, because now to these big firms, $3.5 billion is like a quarter to you and I. Okay? I mean, it's nothing. You know, when we're talking about, you're talking about trillion-dollar valuations. It's actually incredible when you look back in the long-term capital structure to think that $3.5 billion could take down the financial system in general. And what you had there, now this is what the big difference is. And this is my take on a big difference even going forward, folks. And what it is this. Until COVID come, the bottom line is that, yeah, we've always been aware of huge deficits, printing money, all of that. There's no two ways about it, okay? But guess what? The Fed can't back off now. It's impossible to back off. The politicians can't back off. The central banks can't back off. I'm talking about all over the world right now. You know, if you're looking at asset prices, this inflation's coming in, man. You know, because it's the Fed on Tuesday and Wednesday are going to try to figure out how to tell the market once again that lower for longer. And my take is I'm still a bull inside of the note and the bond market, okay? Because they can't back off. If there's any inclination at all that they are going to basically stop buying notes or bonds, this market will take conniptions. And as soon as it takes conniptions, the Federal Reserve, the big banks, you name it, they're all going to come screaming. The amazing part about this is that when you get and you have the deal about Bernie Sanders, Bernie must be going crazy, because for the amount of folks on Wall Street that they claim that they don't want to, you know, that the last thing they want to do is basically give a mother with some kids extra money, not extra money, just money to survive. you touch an aspect of markets going up every single day because of the fact they're getting subsidized by printing money. Okay, the hypocrisy is insane. Let's go to Eddie in Boca Raton. Hey, Eddie, what's going on?
Hey, Tom, how are you, man?
I'm doing great. So you're in GameStop?
Yeah, I'm in GameStop at 60, but I've made about $160,000 already that I cashed out. But I'm back in it. I was back in it. I watched it go up to 159, and the trading got halted. I was up $350,000, and it just tanked from there. Because when the trading got halted, when it opened up, it went down like 20 points. And, you know,
right.
Then,
so why don't you take your money right now?
I'm sorry?
Why don't you take your money right now?
Well, my question was, if the short interest is still high, how do you know that the short squeeze is over?
You don't. But you know, right, it's going to be over.
Yeah.
Take your money, man.
All right,
man. Don't go to sleep on this.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, bam! As well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge. Just $89. Exclusively at TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials down 73, Nasdaq's up 74, S&Ps are up 9. Market just keeps shaking it off, folks. And what is amazing, there's no doubt, if you look at markets in general, most of the time is that when you see bubbles, we're in a bubble, but guess what? Who knows how long a bubble can run? And I'm talking a long period of time. I mean, when we go back to the 90s, that thing ran for a good year and a half. And when I look at this, you could have made the case even the last 2 or 3 months that when all the biotechs run, that normally is the last run inside the marketplace before a market falls apart. This time, okay, you had the biotechs run, then all of a sudden you get all these stories. I mean, we're telling stories now like we're telling stories in 1999, which, guess what? If you could listen to some of those shows, I don't think Google was there in 99. Yeah, but we don't have the shows, I don't believe. But bottom line is that with plenty of folks that were just flat out, then they just weren't going to sell. They were going to just keep going, going, going. So you can see the type of arena that we're in right now. We are definitely in this arena. That being said, I think when we see the numbers that come out this week from those NDX 100 stocks, they're going to be big numbers, because what has happened is that the amount of people, amount of companies that are eating everyone else, that is happening on a dramatic basis, and they're eating them all up. And unfortunately, when Tommy was showing today just the market caps of inside the NDX 100 as well as the S&P 500, they're skewed. They have, you know, you get five or six tech companies that are basically cleaning everything, that are taking everything. There's no doubt about that. So pretty wild, man. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night. Have a safe night. Please come back and visit us tomorrow. Tell your friends about us. Tell them to go to YouTube, search TFNN, subscribe. It's free. We'll get them, folks.